morning and welcome to worship on this Palm Sunday. Unite us in love and spirit as we welcome Jesus into our hearts. It is great to be able to be in worship with you again via our YouTube and TV and website. We pray that you are touched in a special way today. A few announcements to bring to your attention. Please continue to send your joys and concerns so that we can be in prayer with one another and celebration. This week, as we enter into Holy Week, we will be experiencing our services different. We will be having some live streaming during Thursday and Friday evening. Please stay tuned, and if you are interested in having the link, do please call and leave a message in the office. Although the building remains closed, our ministries continue, and so please do leave messages, email, call us. We are here for you. And now let us join together in the call to worship. If you have not downloaded the bulletin, the response for the people is Hosanna to God, Hosanna in the highest. That's the response for each of our intercessions here. Let us join together. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever.
Hosanna to God. Hosanna in the highest.
Let Israel say, his love endures forever. And all who fear God, his love endures forever.
Hosanna to God. Hosanna in the highest.
With the Lord on our side, what can we fear? What can humankind do?
Hosanna to God. Hosanna in the highest.
We shall triumph over those who surround us and stand in confidence in the Lord our God.
Hosanna to God. Hosanna in the highest.
The Lord is our strength and our might. The Lord has become our salvation.
Hosanna to God. Hosanna in the highest.
Let us now join in singing hymn number 280, All Glory, Laud, and Honor. We will sing the first and fifth verse. We have hidden our faces from the pain and suffering of our world. We have turned a deaf ear to the cries of the poor, the hungry, the oppressed. We trust in the slick promotions of the world and not in your words that can transform our lives. Forgive us, steadfast God, and shine your face upon us. Help us to have the same mind as Christ, so we would know your promises. Help us to have the same heart as Christ, so we might serve your children. Help us to have the same spirit as Christ, so we might go wherever you lead us. And now in a moment of silence, I invite you to lift up your own prayers of confession to God.
Thank you.
The gospel reading for today comes from the gospel according to Matthew, the 21st chapter, first 11 verses. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethpage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this: the Lord needs them, and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Oh God, you speak to us in so many ways, and we thank you that we have already heard your voice and felt your spirit. Continue to open us up, that the message which is the one you have prepared and which you have placed upon our hearts is the one we hear, which we latch onto, and which we follow. Amen. So not exactly the Palm Sunday I envisioned when we started Lent. Today was supposed to be a day for us to wave palms, to shout Hosanna, and celebrate Holy Communion together. But you know what? The first Palm Sunday wasn't what the people envisioned either. They expected a lot of pomp and circumstance. Their hero riding in on a white steed covered in military garb and going to overthrow the Roman government. Instead, they got a humble man on a donkey. And did you hear? The whole city was in turmoil. We are in a stir of turmoil here, not only here in our city, but in the whole world. And yet our king still comes, humble, in the most unassuming ways. This is the day the Lord has made. Say the response with me. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Where have you seen God at work over these last few weeks? I've seen the Spirit move in many ways. Someone we put on the prayer list last week was on a ventilator. He was taken off of it yesterday and was able to FaceTime his family. While he was on the ventilator, his son celebrated a birthday. Now he was able to see him, and his son was able to see his dad. And I couldn't help but be amazed at the hero's welcome the FDNY gave to the doctors and nurses as they went into the New York City hospitals. I imagine that was how it might have been when Jesus came to town, a reversal of sorts. We now have new heroes, like those who don scrubs, those who stitch masks in their basements, those who sit behind cameras and help to make the technology work. By choosing a donkey, Jesus comes as the King of Peace, ensuring steadfast love, a steadfast love which endures forever. And not only does he come on a donkey, but a colt trotted alongside. These were signs of vulnerability and peacefulness. Where have you seen vulnerability and peacefulness over the last few weeks? This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. Not yesterday, not tomorrow, but today. What can you be glad in today? I know for some of us this might be extremely difficult, especially if you're mourning the loss of a loved one, or you're isolated, scared, or sick. But I encourage you to try. God is with you. We enter into Holy Week in a very different way this week. But again, not so much differently than that first Holy Week. There was fear. There was doubt. There was fleeing. There was denying. We may experience all these feelings this week. And I encourage you to feel them. Now, I know that sounds like I am contradicting what I just said about rejoicing and being glad. But I believe this is a both and, not an either or. Henry Nouwen, the great priest, professor, writer, and theologian, said, "Joy is hidden in sorrow, and sorrow in joy." If we try to avoid sorrow at all costs, we may never taste joy. And if we are suspicious of ecstasy, agony can never reach us. Agony can never reach us either. Joy and sorrow are the parents of our spiritual growth. This Holy Week, unlike any other, has given us the perfect opportunity to grow spiritually. We are in our own spaces. We are in those prayer closets like we read about on Ash Wednesday, where Jesus said, "Go into those secret places and be with me." So I encourage you to take time each day during this Holy Week to contemplate Jesus' walk to the cross. Read the Passion account in the Bible. Watch one of the movies online. Allow yourself to feel those feelings. I plan to read and meditate using Henry Nouwen's book, Out of Solitude, this week. So, those of you who know me know how I say ad infinitum. I love how God works. And that I believe there are no coincidences, only God incidences. So someone in one of the Bible studies this week, and I apologize to who you are, but I forgot who asked me. But they asked which Henry Nouwen book I would most recommend. And I said, "Well, I'm not sure. There's so many good ones. Nothing came to mind." So I said I would go back and look on my bookshelf. And so that's what I did. I looked on my bookshelf at the books that I had of his, and I found this one. And listen to what it says in the preface. He gives thanks to those who helped him and who provided him support as he wrote these meditations. Sisters of Mercy of Madison, Connecticut, who offered a hospitable place to write. So this was written in 1974, well before I even imagined I would be coming to Clinton. And so imagine that now I pick this up to read during Holy Week, just a mile away from Madison, when we are to be in solitude. Surely, God has placed this in my path to meditate on this week. So that's another thing I rejoice about. God's steadfast love endures forever, and it comes to us in the most amazing ways. God is putting things in our paths. God is guiding us to be intentional about being with Him this week. Take time to ponder this. Take time to be in solitude. Take time to meditate. And take time to look around and see the things which bring us joy. So as I said, this week will be different, and we will be celebrating the days of Holy Thursday and contemplating Good Friday in different ways. But yet I am certain God will be with us in a new and very powerful way. So open up your heart. And then, believe me, when we take time to go through this journey with Christ this week, when we gather again together and celebrate the risen Savior, it will be like any other celebration we've ever experienced. No matter what the Gregorian calendar says, when we come back together again, we will be celebrating Easter. God's steadfast love endures forever. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. It is now time to think about the offerings that we can give to God. One thing I encourage you to think about this week is normally we have an altar filled with Easter flowers. This year we won't be able to have the flowers filling our sanctuary, but we can still give of ourselves and give a donation in honor or memory of someone. So I encourage you to think about that as you give your offering this week. Who is it that you would like to say a special thank you to? Who is it that you are feeling especially close to? Who are you mourning? Send your offering in. Email us, let us know. We want to still uplift those prayers. So now let us receive our morning offering as we give back to God our tithes and our gifts. Let us join together in the prayer of dedication. Holy God, sovereign over power and pain, glorious triumph over deep disappointment, we enter this holy week offering our tithes and offerings to you in the hope please continue to share your joys and your concerns. Let us lift them up in a moment of silence now. O God, on this holy day, we have so many mixed feelings inside of us. We thank you that Jesus came with the triumphant entry. We thank you that we can shout, Hosanna, save us. Blessed are you who came. And yet we too feel sorrow. Sorrow for what we see on the news. Sorrow for those who are close to us. Sorrow for you and what you experienced that week as the shouts turned from Hosanna to crucify. But God, we thank you. We thank you that you took our pain, that you loved us so much, you were willing to go to the cross for us. Oh God, we thank you that in you there is hope. In you there is love. There is salvation for all. Help us to share that hope with those who are in need. Help us to share your love in the world in a new way. Help us to continue to spread the message of your salvation to a hurting world. Heal us, O God. Transform us. Renew us. Draw us closer to you than we've ever been before as we journey during this holiest of weeks. Empower us with your strength, your courage, and with the assurance that you are with us through the valleys and on the mountaintops. No matter what we may face, we do not face it alone, but with you by our side. And it is in the name of our precious Savior, the one who was willing to die for us, that we pray all of this. Amen. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.